it's complete now, so I'm not sure if I'm gonna put stuff on it just yet. I just realized though that it's gonna serve a better purpose than just books. I can actually, like, look at this real quick. I don't know if I'm gonna have to adjust settings. Like, all this stuff, right? Like, my speaker, this little bag, which I have, like, some just random miscellaneous stuff, like chargers and whatever, just cards, random gift cards, whatever. Like, my headphones, my camera bag, you know, just random small stuff, you know, even all the stuff that's cluttered over there on that little shelf. I can put them, like, put, like, my expensive stuff up here. That way, in case it falls all down or something, nothing gets crushed or something. I don't know. But I still gotta organize, like, what I'm gonna do, what I'm gonna put on each shelf. So, I'll have a video. I'll cut to the next frame, and I'll actually have it all set up and organized. So. I did not end up putting it here, because it was, like, tilted a little bit. It looked kind of weird. So, I'm gonna show you guys, like, where I ended up putting it. So, I was gonna put it over there, but it actually fit way better right here. So I just took this wall, the hanging thing down picture, and I had a mirror right here, sitting right here. They both did not need to be there. I was just kind of like lazy, didn't move them yet. They were just like kind of like things that I meant to put in storage. But as you can see, this thing is like, look, if you need a bookshelf, you need to go to Target and fucking get one. It was only $35, and this thing is like solid. Like, it's super high quality, you know? I put all my, like, stuff I use that's kind of expensive up here. Like, I have this bag full of chargers and stuff. Headphones, my fanny pack, like, everyday stuff, like, wallet, whatever. And then my camera bag right up here. Then I got my books. The ones in the basement are primarily, like, Stephen King books. I got them, like, forever ago, back when I didn't have a driver's license, if that tells you anything. It was like this sale at this library. My mom took me when we were like Rod Chandler or something. And all like paperbacks were like 50 cents and all hardcovers were a dollar. And I walked away with like literally like 30 books because they were all Stephen King and I wanted to read them all. But I didn't, I only read like a couple of them. But I have like a small collection of like a majority of those are thrifted except for the ones up here. There's a couple of thrifted ones in there. But they're primarily ones that I bought, like, on Amazon or elsewhere because they were books I specifically wanted to read, and I wasn't going to wait till I randomly came across it at a thrift store. So, yeah, that's where I put my bookshelf. It's amazing. Actually, it cleaned up my room a whole bunch, so I'm very happy. I feel very organized. My closet is a lot cleaner. So I'm currently in the middle of doing some deep cleaning because, long story short, I've got to wait about another week before I can start that job with Nate. And I got all this free time on my hands, and I'd be dumb if I didn't take advantage of this time to like do some like deep fucking cleaning. I'm talking like just things that you don't even think about, like every drawer. Like, that's my closet, right? Every drawer underneath the dresser, like to the sides, everything up there. I've been getting rid of all of it. And if I want to keep whatever's up there, I put it in a storage tote in the basement. Basically, I'm trying to be move out ready when that time comes. If I already got everything in storage totes, I'm gonna be golden. So what I'm doing right now is this stack of papers. Oh, that stack of papers was old calendar papers, whatever. I don't know why, I tend to be a hoarder sometimes. So I had my last year's calendar like saved. I'm like, man, what the fuck am I doing? So I took all the papers out. I'm just gonna shred them because I'd be writing like email addresses and passwords on them and stuff. So I grabbed the shredder, my mom's shredder. So I'm about to shred those up. And I'm probably gonna go through those drawers next and empty out those drawers. And then go from there, because I already cleaned up top, and I guess we'll see what's next. All right, so I'm in the basement now, getting everything organized, getting all my stuff together. Probably gonna try and put it all to like one side or like one corner. Everything under the stairs here, I took everything out and looked through every box to make sure I had nothing. Stuff back there, like this tall dresser, and then there's clothes on top of it that are mine. The main thing that I have to go through is like all these old clothes, so, or and new, just to organize them. So those three things right there, those are all mine, sorted fashions. And then I've got this pile of clothes, that pile of clothes, and I got bags of clothes over there and tubs and whatnot. But what I was thinking was that I have to get all of this organized and then all of that organized back there. All right, little update. It's been like, I don't know, like 2 to 3 hours. And I just got done eating and I had to cook, so that took me like an hour. So really I've only been down here for like an hour and a half, 2 hours. And so far, I've gotten through a shitload of stuff. So I cleared off this entire rack and this entire rack of things I don't need. These are things I want to sell because I just feel like, honestly, like they've served me so well and I love them so much, but they either don't fit me or they're just not like my style anymore. But they're in like damn near brand new condition. So there's this jacket, it's just really cool. I found this Polaroid hoodie a while ago. This is like 90s shirt, just doesn't fit me. This brand new Tommy shirt with the collar on it. Calvin Klein, another Calvin Klein, giving that to my girlfriend. This cool shirt and this Adidas jacket. But I got everything off the top of this, and the only drawer that has clothes in it is that bottom one because I haven't got to it yet. I just took all those drawers and emptied them into this basket. I've been putting them in this basket as I sort them. This is everything that I wanted to keep out of everything. And then I'm going to see if I can find like one of those places like Plato's Closet or something to sell these jeans, because they're all Levi's or Hollister, American Eagle, like really, really good quality jeans that people would still pay good money for. This is everything that's going to the Goodwill, and then I'm giving this to my friend, one of my friends, Nate, because he likes that stuff and we're slightly different sizes. It's still really good stuff, it just doesn't fit me. I've gotten a little bigger. And then this is all stuff my other friend Jake is going to go through, because I think this is stuff that he would be interested in. Again, it's just stuff that doesn't fit me. So it's not necessarily that it's like just like terrible condition stuff. It's just stuff that either just doesn't fit me or just isn't necessarily my style anymore. Primarily stuff that doesn't fit me, because this stuff has been on here for over 5 years. And I don't remember the last time I went through all my clothes to get rid of them. It was probably over 5 years ago. I did find a pair of Levi's, or two pairs of Levi's. They were the first pairs I initially bought when I first was serious about getting some cool clothes when I was like 16. These right here, they're 33-34s, which I usually wear about that size anyways. But the way they fit, they used to be like kind of baggy. And then I stopped wearing them because they were baggy. But that was kind of like my style then, before I really had a good sense of... Before I really had my own sense of style, I wore a little bit like baggy jeans. But I remember I paid like $70 per pair at Macy's for those, because that was the only place they had like the exact size, like 33-34. They usually only have 32s or 34s, but I was able to find the 33s there. And when I found them, I was like, I almost put them like directly in the pile where I was gonna sell them or give them away. But then I put them on and they fit like amazing now that I've gotten more muscle on my legs and stuff. They fit like damn near perfect. So I have those two pairs. I totally forgot about those. And then I still have yet to go through any of the clothes over there and anything I might have over here. But this corner over there, over here, was like a huge, huge project on its own, as well as all my hampers. So, I mean, as you can see, I got a lot of stuff here that needs to go. Currently heading to Goodwill. I didn't really show the bags that I have like all together, but there's 4 total bags and like 1 box full of random stuff that I'm taking to the Goodwill to donate it, because I also threw away like 4 total bags of trash, and anything that I thought had any kind of value or reusability, I just put it in the box and I'm gonna give it away. And then I've got like all these board games and stuff right here. And I asked Brad if he wanted them, and he said he'll take them. I know they always do family game night, so he's going to get those. So after I head to the Goodwill, I'm going to the gym with Jake. I got to stop by the supplement shop and get some energy drinks and a really big bottle of water, because I'm out of my distilled gallons.
So forgive me, Lord. I was gonna pick some up, but they were all out at Kroger, so. Yeah, and then after that, we're gonna meet up with Brad and Jared and Wyandotte at Ed's, get some coffee at this coffee shop that he said was really good. And for the moment we've all been waiting for, I'm gonna switch the lens on this. So I'm at my usual frame rate. I'm at a 4 aperture and I'm at 2000 ISO. So I'm about to switch the lens in the same angle right now. And we're gonna see how it is. We're gonna see how low that ISO has to be. So here we go. Do you see that background right now? No, it's blurry as fuck. That depth of field, bro. Look at this. I'm running the 1.4 aperture right now at 400 ISO. I had to have 2000 ISO to have the same lighting and the same exposure. Oh, this is like an extendo on the camera. I can't even believe it. The camera is a little heavier now, but this is too good. Brad, thank you. I love you so much. So I know this one was kind of random, but I'm just going to throw it all together. There's really no conclusion to the whole basement scenario other than I got rid of like a whole bunch of stuff, like 5 bags of clothing and like 4 or 5 bags of trash. So that's just like the start of it. I was able to do that all in 1 week because I had the whole week, I had like 2 weeks off, and I decided that second week that I would start doing that. And now I have my first day of work today at like 4 o'clock. So what I'll do is slowly over time now, I'm going to organize my things and get them together, get ready to move essentially. Cause I got to move like within 4 months starting November 1st. So I'll be good. It's just, I got a lot done. I was in there down in the basement like 6 hours a day since like last Monday, and today is Monday. So like the whole week, I was in there for like, you know, it almost took me like 30 or 40 hours almost. So yeah, this is just the conclusion of this. I got the new lens, so looks beautiful. Catch you guys in the next one.